Jasyasti bhaktir bhagavati yakinchana sarvaguna istatra samasati suraha haro abhakta sukuto mahadguna manorathena sato dhavato vahi Jasyasti bhaktir bhagavati yakinchana sarvaguna istatra samasati suraha Haro abhaktasya kuto mahadgunaha mano rathena asato dhavato vahi. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told Prana Chajar Sehitu Pachar. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada told Prana Chajar Sehitu Pachar. If you have life, then you can go for preaching. If there is no life in your body, then you cannot go for preaching. It is useless. What do you mean? We are a living creature. Why you speak like that? Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, actually, Shikhai Saranagati Bhaktir Pran. Bhaktivinoda Thakur explaining this point. Shikhai Saranagati Bhaktir Pran. Prabhupada speaking, Va Prana Chaya Sehetu Prasad. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur explaining this point. What do you mean by pran? Life. Life, vitals of your life is your Saranagati. Without Saranagati, there is no question of any preaching. If there is no bhakti with you, what you can preach. Actually, in Chaitanya Charitamrita, one point is there that Krishna Shakti Vina Nahi Bhakti Pavartan. You must learn Bengali. My Guru Maharaj used to speak repeatedly. If you can learn Bengali, you can enjoy the test. Actually, so many Siddhanta there in Chaitanya Bhagavad Chaitanya Charitamrita. But if you can understand language, still you cannot understand Siddhanta, I know. But for that, you will have to approach a sadhu, actual guru. If there is no Krishna Shakti, Krishna Shakti bina nahi bhakti pavartan, Krishna Shakti, without Krishna Shakti, you cannot preach. Bhakti, What you like to preach? Actually, you like to preach bhakti. You like to give bhakti to others. That is preaching. But you cannot do properly if you don't have Krishna Shakti. Actually, point is there. Srila Bhakti Daita Madhava Goswami Maharaj is such a big, gigantic personality. If you go through his life, you can understand. What kind of saranagati, what kind of, you know, seva in his whole life he has done, actually. Srinivas Acharya, you know Srinivas Acharya? Srinivas Acharya always used to sing, speak this point, Balavan adaro adaro yasso nasad guru padam bhuye surtoi ropita sosa sastrair krishne bhakti najayati. Srinivasaji used to speak that if there is no Guru Bhakti, if you have strong affinity for Guru Charan, then you can get Krishna Bhakti. Srinivasaji speaking, the Balavan Adaru Yasu Nasad Guru Padam Bhuje Srutoi Ropitasu Sasastra Krishna Bhakti Najayati. You can read Ved, Vedanta, Upanishad, Puran, everything you can memorize, you can read. But still you cannot get one drop of bhakti. Bhakti is so rare. But if Guru Bhakti is there, if you have strong affinity, strong bhakti unto the lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma, Sadguru, then you can get Krishna Bhakti very easily. Now the sloka I started with is that akinchana bhakti. Akinchana bhakti means pure bhakti. If there is no desire inside your heart, no smell of any desire inside your heart, then it is called akinchana bhakti. Akinchana bhakti means there is no desire, no condition, unconditional submission, unconditional service unto the lotus feet of Gurupath Padma and Vaishnava Bhagavan. That is called akinchana bhakti, pure bhakti. Those who are not having akinchana bhakti, mano rathen asato davato bohi, those who are material person, they have different kind of desire. Their mind is not under their control. They cannot get control over their mind. So their whimsical mind can pull here and there like madman. In Gita, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking in front of in front of Arjun speaking, it is quite impossible to get control over my mind. Mind is very restless. Krishna Bhagavan speaking, yes, you are right. But abhyaseno tu kantiyo vairagyano cha grihate. If you go on doing practice, if you are practicing under the guidance of a Sadguru, then today or tomorrow you can get control over your mind. Without controlling your mind, or any kind of bhajan is useless. Savan Kirtan or Pada Sevan, any kind of ninefold of bhakti, you cannot come out successful. Jasyasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana sarva gunais tatro samasati suraha haro avakta sakuto mahat guna mano rathen asato dhavato bhai. Jasyasti, those who are having niskinchana, akinchana bhakti, akinchana bhakti, sarva gunais tatra samasati suraha. Those demigods, Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving advice to Uddhava, those who are taking sannyas and brahmachari, for them it is very dangerous, because the demigods, primarily, they like to stop him doing bhajan. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking to Uddhava, demigods, they are actually, they cannot allow you to do bhajan. They are against you. Because those demigods, they are thinking, they are going out of our control. Demigods speaking, Jivatma going out of our control. So we must stop him going. We don't like to allow him to go this way. But after that, if say Jogmaya, when Mahamaya, first of all, Mahama like to stop you, but when you are enjoying full Guru Kripa, then Mahama cannot stop you, then after that, Jogmaya can help you. First of all, Mahamaya, Jogmaya same. Mahamaya, internal potency there is Jogmaya. And external potency is Mahamaya. Shadow. If Jogmaya is not there, then you cannot get the existence of Mahamaya. Jogmaya is there, that's why you can get the shadow. Sisti, Siti, Polaya, Sadhana, Shakti, Reka. This book, you see, Brahma Sangita, you can say, Chayeva Jasya Bhavanani Vibharti Durga. Durga means Chaya Shakti, shadow. Durga Devi cannot allow you to do perfect bhajan, illimitably. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing one nice kirtan, Kulo Devi Jogmaya More Kripa Kori. You heard this kirtan? Kulo Devi Jogmaya More Kripa Kori, Avaram Sangbirubi Tumi Vishwadhari. Sunechi Agam Vede Mahima Tomar, Sri Krishna Vimukhe Dhari Karao Sansar, Sri Krishna Sanmukha Jar Bhagyakame Hoy, Tare Mukti Diya Karo Ashoka Bhai. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing kirtan, Kulo Devi Jogmaya More Kripa Kori, Avaram Sangbiribe তুমি কৃপা করি। আবরণ মিন দেয়ার ইজ এ স্ক্রিন, আবরণ মিন দেয়ার ইজ এ স্ক্রিন, বিহাইন্ড দ্য স্ক্রিন দেয়ার ইজ ট্রান্সেন্ডেন্টাল ওয়ার্ল্ড, বাট হিয়ার দিস মেটেরিয়াল ওয়ার্ল্ড, দ্য স্ক্রিন প্রোটেক্টিং ইউ, মানে আই মিন দ্যাট স্ক্রিন ক্যান নট অ্যালাউ ইউ টু সি দ্যাট ট্রান্সেন্ডেন্টাল ওয়ার্ল্ড। দ্যাটস ওয়াই দ্য ভক্তিবিনোদ ঠাকুর মানে প্রেয়িং টু লোটাস ফিট অফ মহামায়া কুলদেবী যোগমায়া, মোহরি কৃপা করি, ইফ ইউ আর মার্সিফুল টু মি প্লিজ প্লিজ ইউ আনভেল দ্য স্ক্রিন সো দ্যাট আই ক্যান সি, সো দ্যাট আই ক্যান ডু ভজন পারফেক্টলি দিস প্রেয়িং। দোজ হু আর উইলিং 100% ফর দেম যোগমায়া হেল্পিং, then Mahamaya stop his activities. So, first of all, those who are demigods, they first of all, they are against you, but when they find Jogamaya already helping you, Mahamaya stop every all activities, then actually they are also in favor of you. After that they are in. After that, finally those demigods, they always like to help you, that not fast. So, if you are successful sannyas, if you are sannyas means, not that sannyas don't, you think sannyas means one danda is there, red cloth, but sannyas means totally you are dedicated. Vishnubhya Devi sannyas, Jannabha Devi sannyas, Sinibhasacharya sannyas, they are all sannyas. Sannyas means those who are learning Sanskrit, those who are having good knowledge in Sanskrit, they can explain this way, Sat plus Nyas. Sat means that absolute truth. Unto the lotus feet of that absolute truth, if you are going to throw yourself unto the lotus feet of that absolute truth, that is called Sannyas. Sat plus Nyas. Nyas means to keep, to throw himself. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sankirtan Yajna in Siva Sangam, long ago, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and lighting their Sankirtan Yajna there. Prabhupada speaking, those who are ready to throw their life, to dedicate their life unto the lotus feet of the absolute truth, I mean unto this fire sacrifice of Sankirtan Yajna, they are actually Gaudiya. Other people, they are not actually Gaudiya. They can deserve, we have sannyas, we have danda. Actually, they are not actually sannyas. Sannyas means so to dedicate whole life for Krishna, for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Anyway, so those demigods, finally they are going to help you. Always and every time, non-stop they are. Always, wherever you go, all demigods protecting you. Nobody can do anything, any harmful against you. They are always protecting. So, sarva gunais tattra samasate suraha haru abhaktasya kuto mahat gunaha. Those who are not devotees, you can think they have nice qualities. Material people sometimes some material people can have nice qualities. In this material world, you can find some personality there, so nice qualities there. But still, you cannot compare that quality with the quality already having in a Vaishnava. If you think, well, Madhava Goswami have this kind of quality, I have seen in my village. One person and one master was their school master, his same quality. You cannot speak this way. If you speak this way, then it is very offensive, because those, their headmaster, who is having that, it seems that kind of quality is there in him. But still you cannot compare that quality with that Vaishnava qualities. Because his quality is material quality. He is under the influence of Maya, three modes of nature. He is not out of the influence of three modes of nature. So his quality is not pure. But Paramahamsa Madhava Goswami, his quality is pure. So you cannot compare. This is the Siddhanta, you see. So material people, they can have different kind of qualities, very, very nice qualities, but their qualities not of prakrit qualities. Now, actually, we like to explain this point, how to do Guru Seva. But I like to follow Parampiva Bhakti to Madhava Goswami Maharaj. So Madhava Goswami Maharaj took birth there in at present Bangladesh, some place. I am not explaining this point. I like to explain the way he have done Seva already, Prabhupada, dedicated life. Actually, one day Prabhupada asking to all of his, disciples. One day all disciples there, and Prabhupada asking to each one of them, what kind of Seva you like? What kind of Seva you like? Sannyasi, some Brahmacharya speaking, Prabhupada, I like this kind of Seva. Some Brahmacharya asking, Prabhupada asking, what Seva you like? Is that, this kind of Seva I like. After that, ultimately, Prabhupada asking, Hayagrip Brahmachari. His Brahmachari name was Hayagrip Brahmachari. Hayagrip Prabhu, what kind of Seva you like? They express in different kind of opinion, what kind of Seva you like. Then Hayagrip Brahmachari is saying, Prabhupada, when you give me order, any Seva if you give me order, after completing the Seva, whenever you give order for another Seva, any Seva I like. Madhava Goswami Maharaj, Hayagrip Brahmacharya speaking this way. And ultimately, Prabhupada was bound to speak this way, that Hayagrip Brahmacharya is a volcanic eruption, volcanic energy, like volcanic energy. This kind of energy we cannot see in this material world, impossible. I am not giving any story, speaking any story. You cannot imagine even. Actually, one day Paramahansa Madhava Goswami Maharaj is coming from a distant place, long distance. His train was supposed to reach in Howrah 7 o'clock, 2 hours late maybe. 9 o'clock reaching, then crossing river, coming here, back where Gaudi Mat, Prabhupada was there. Around 10 o'clock, after taking bath everything, then Prabhupada asking, Hayagrip Prabhu, where from you are coming? Prabhupada, you give me this seva, I complete, I am coming. Now you get ready, around 12 o'clock your train is there from Howrah. You will have to go now, take prasada, now and go. Then Madhava Goswami Maharaj become ready. This way, volcanic energy, this kind of energy of seva, you cannot expect. Nowadays is impossible. Actually, at present, situation is very bad. If my opinion is not in favor of Guru Maharaj's opinion, then I am going to leave my Guru Maharaj. This is a condition. If my opinion, personal opinion, is not telling Guru Maharaj's opinion, I can easily leave my Guru Maharaj, I can throw Guru Maharaj, I can take another Guru, new Guru. That's why we are actually Mayavadi. Don't feel sorry for that. Prabhupada speak this way. We are more or less contaminated with Mayavad Vichar Siddhanta. Some kind of contamination is there inside our heart. So somehow we are actually somehow contaminated our heart with Mayavad Vichar, more or less. What do you mean? Prabhupada want to speak, what is the basic Siddhanta of Mayavad? What is the basic Siddhanta? I don't like to explain this Mayavad, so I can explain after. But what is the basic Siddhanta of Mayavad? Basic Siddhanta of Mayavad means, we cannot believe Guru Vaishnava, we cannot believe the Leela of Krishna, any Leela of Krishna, Mane Bhagavan, we disbelieve. A Mayavadi never believe Krishna Lila Nitya, Guru Vaishnava Nitya, they don't believe. For infinity period, Guru Vaishnava Kipa is there, Guru Vaishnava, they don't believe. They think it is temporary. We can accept Guru, but after realizing Brahma, we can live Guru. That is their Guru Puja. They are also doing Guru Puja. Their Guru Puja apparently is more than you. You can arrange Guru Puja big way. But their Guru Puja is more than you. They are doing Guru Puja big, enthusiastic way. But their heart is not there, cooperating. If heart is there, then the action is positive. But heart is not there. Heart is not there. If your heart is not there, then that kind of activities. If your heart is not there, any action you are doing, then your action is absurd, negative. That's why Radharani, in front of those, Dwarkavasi, in front of Krishna, told this way. In Bengali. That's why I repeatedly request you to learn Bengali. You can get a taste. Radharani crying and speaking in front of Krishna when they meet midway. Brajavasis, they are going midway. They are coming from Dwarka in Kurukshetra, one place. As the place, that place is very ideal place for Raganuga Bhajan, Rupanuga Bhajan. A feeling of separation is very strong there. Yet, Bhaktivinoda Thakur also speaking this way. This Purushottam Khetra is the topmost place for Raganuga Bhajan. A feeling of separation you can get very strongly there in Kurukshetra, and Puri. Because that time you cannot see Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Now Gauranga Mahaprabhu, we can see that Gauranga Mahaprabhu manifesting Leela there, Nitya Leela. That time nobody can know. Only Gorgo Muni and that kind of super personalities, so they knowing everything. But common people, they don't know. Who is Gauranga Mahaprabhu? They don't know. But those who are having good knowledge in scripture, they know. Gauru Leela is also Nitya. So Radharani, they are crying in front of Krishna and speaking, Aner hidaye mon, mor mon bindavan, mone bone ek kori mani. Radharani speaking, for common people, those who are ordinary people, their heart is different, mind is different. Not parallel. Follow my point. What they are thinking in mind, heart is there, different, scattered. Not in line. Antara bahire samabhyabohar, amani manodahavu. What do you mean by antara bahire samabhyabohar? Mean? Inside heart and mind, when parallel, then antara bahire samabhyabohar. Inside heart and mind, when parallel, then it is very favorable for Krishna Bhajan. Those who are kapat, you know? Those who are kapat, for them heart and mind not parallel. They can speak something, Maharaj, Dandavad, inside there they are thinking something, different thing. So it's not time. So, if you like to be a big devotee, sadhu, first of all you have to point this point. What Radhan is speaking, that you see, for common people, their mind and heart is different. But my heart, if I can open in front of you, you can see that Vrindavan is there. My heart is just equal to Vrindavan. My heart is 10%, 100% equal to Vrindavan. Vrindavan is my heart. And you are already there. So, actually point is that if you are advising me this way, I cannot bear. Because my heart is Vrindavan. Without Vrindavan, I cannot live. Like without water, a fish cannot live. Without water, fish can live? No. So without Vrindavan, I can. If you can go to Vrindavan, again if you start doing this kind of Leela, then we can live. Otherwise, we are 100% we are going to die very shortly. We are alive. Why? Because we are keeping hope that shortly we are. This hope, for this kind of positive hope, we are just living. Otherwise, 100% we are going to die this way. So, actually, Panbhya Madhava Goswami is speaking this way, actually. That you see, actually, whenever you give me order for any seva, after completing this way, if you give me another seva, go and do this seva, then I like to this kind of seva. Actually, Paramahansa Madhava Goswami Maharaj, when came first, taking the permission of mother, father was not there, from childhood, father, when took permission from mother, because from childhood, his life is totally different, not like ordinary people. Ganesh is known as Ganesh. The schoolmaster, they could realize that that boy is totally different, not like ordinary man. Then after that, completing college education, everything, university education, Paramahansa Madhava Goswami, when he was young, too young. After that, he took permission from mother, I cannot stay in home. I like to do bhajan. The mother gave permission, blessing. Okay, you can go. No problem. After that, he going to Himalaya first. Going to Himalaya. First of all, he going to Himalaya. Though he is an eternal person of Prabhupada, but still they are manifesting this kind of leela. This kind of leela. So he first going to Himalaya, doing austerity in finances there, doing bhajan. I mean, not taking scepter of any guru. Preliminary is trying. So after that, aerial advice came. Akashvani. Hey, why you are staying here? Your Gurudev is there in Bengal, Bangla. You go to Mayapur there, you can meet your Gurudev there. After getting really aerial order, he said, well, my Gurudev is there. Then he took decision to go come here in Bengal. Then after that, you see, he came here and while coming back here, I mean, he is coming down from Himalaya. Then after that, Haridwar. He is staying for some days there in Haridwar, taking bath in Ganga, very nice place. After that, one rich, couple came, husband and wife, Marwadi, coming. And he saw that boy, man is very nice, that young man is very nice. They coming to discuss with him. After discussing, find very super personality, very so soft personality, very nice looking. They saw, my boy, we have no son, no children. If you like to come, we have billions of dollars with a very big property. We can give to you. You like to be, if you are going to accept us as a father and mother, then you please come. Then after that, probably we are. Madhava Goswami speaking, no, my life is not for property and anything. I like to do bhajan. After that, Madhava Goswami coming straightway here in Bangla. And first of all, he's with some friends, Narayan Ghosh, like that, I forget name, Narayan Mukhopadhyay. He met with a college friend. Together with friends, he is coming here in Mayapur to take darshan. Because he already heard about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, this, that. Then he is going to Chaitanya Math. By then, Chaitanya Math was established. So he is waiting to take darshan of, Mahaprabhu in temple. Then he is waiting. After taking darshan, the young boy, so nice. So nice personality, you see, and they are going back. Then by chance they meet Prabhupada. Prabhupada looking at them. Then they pay dandavat to Prabhupada. Prabhupada asking, what for you are coming to Mayapur? To take darshan of deities and to take darshan of Dham. Your darshan done? Your darshan is complete? What do you mean? Your darshan is complete? You see deities? After that, Prabhupada started Harikatha. This kind of darshan is not perfect darshan. When you are coming in front of deity, we are not going to watch deity. We have no right. Rather, we will have to represent ourselves in such a way so that deity become interested to see us. Prabhupada speaking this way. They never heard this kind of, what do you mean? Now you see, Then they go and hearing Prabhupada for some days. After that they go mad. They are going mad. What kind of harikatha? So powerful Prabhupada. You see, if somebody is looking at Prabhupada, they cannot stop looking at Prabhupada. Someday, I asked Parampuja, Santu Goswami Maharaj, we never see Prabhupada. That time actually no recorder, no nice camera, nothing. But still some picture was there. But we cannot see the direct, the appearance of Prabhupada. Then, Parampuja, Santu Goswami Maharaj speaking, you see, in whole world, if you search and find out nice ladies, so beautiful ladies, you bring from whole world and put you in one room and put Prabhupada among them inside, make one seat. And if anybody coming first into that room, they are bound to look at Prabhupada, so tej, so power. So effulgence, so beautiful. You have no chance to look at any ladies. You are bound to look at Prabhupada. So now you understand. I say, oh, so nice example. So Prabhupada, you see, one day some thief came in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to steal ordinary thing. Papita, this kind of thing, ordinary thing. We are poor Muslim, stealing something, he is going to have some green coconut of this guy. Then by chance, Prabhupada coming out of room from library. And he had the chance to look at Prabhupada, that thief. He already climbed the, that fences. Then he look at Prabhupada. He cannot jump and go away. Just like magnet, Prabhupada look at him and catch him. Just magnet. He cannot jump. If he jump, he can go away. Because he already climbed that, you know, this kind of power is there, Prabhupada. So after hearing his friend, Madhava Goswami Maharaj and his friends, they are very interested to take shelter unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada. They took shelter nicely. After that, Parampuja High Guru Brahmachari become number one seva, topmost seva. Who? Everybody doing seva or Guru Varga. What I am speaking up and down, I am not thinking. But still, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that time there is no property of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Actually, externally if you watch, there is no money, no facility, nothing there. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming from the transcendental world. There is all kind of facility. But externally you cannot find facility. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you see, that time, the condition of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was not so high. I mean, financial. So that time actually, Paramjiva, Hayagi Brahmachari, and you see, Hayagi Brahmachari and Goswami Maharaj, you know, the Aprakita Prabhu, his name was Aprakita Prabhu. The two, they are always doing seva for Chaitanya, round the clock, they are doing seva. They are going for begging, this viviksha, preaching, always, every time they are doing seva, non-stop seva. Day and night, they are going to market for seva, bhiksha, this, that, always they are helping Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all the time. Then you see, actually, Assam preaching, here, there, Punjab preaching, all done by Paramya Madhav Goswami Maharaj. Those who are actually Mayabadi belt. I told you one point just before. What do you mean by Mayavadi belt? Don't become sorry. Because Prabhupada told Mayavad basic siddhanta means if you don't have 100% belief in Guru Vaishnava, Dham, Naam, Parikar, Vaishishta, then more or less Mayavad contamination is there. That's why Prabhupada told, more or less we are contaminated with Mayavad Siddhanta. So, though apparently we are devotee, we like to do seva, still, if there is 0.01% disbelief in Krishna, Harinam, Dham, Nam, then we are little Mayavad. Not 100% pure devotee. There is a point actually. So, Mayavad belt means Punjab, Mayavadi belt, puro Mayavadi belt, SM, Mayavadi belt. They don't believe. So, this, you can say strong belt. Preaching is not so easy. Dakshin Bharat, Kerala, this, that, they are all Mayavadi. Most of them, Shankar Siddhanta they are having, and some of them having Ramanuja Siddhanta, some of them Madhvacharya, some Nimbarka, some. Not big influences there of Mayavadis, which are. And at present, some Christian and influence Christianity is there also. So, if you can go there and preach, then you can understand what kind of preaching you will have to do. Strong, still today. At the time of Prabhupada preaching in South India, Kabur, here, there, you know, Andhra, Mysore, here, there, in Tamil Nadu, Madras, everywhere Prabhupada, still, today, more and more preaching is necessary there. Still today, they are not at all ready to approve Krishna Leela, Radharani Krishna Leela. Their mind is so septic. Still today, they are not ready to accept. They think it is not authentic, Radha Govinda Leela, still today. So you see, it's very strong. They still today, they don't believe. At the time of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they are preaching. After that, so many Mahapurus, they came, they are preaching. But still, more and more preaching. So now actually, so Assam preaching and Punjab preaching, almost all done by Paramya Madhava Goswami Maharaj. Almost all. After Prabhupada, he was the first person. Nobody else. He was the first person to take trouble. For preaching in Punjab and Assam, everywhere. So hard preaching. Assam is almost, you know, forest, you see. Those who are living in Assam, their brain is blockheaded, you see, most of them. They don't like to, yes, most of them. Yes, they don't like to believe. They are very angry attitude. So one day, you see, Paramya Madhava Goswami Maharaj, he is going for preaching with some of his disciples, Paramya Bhakti Vallabh, Krishna Vallabh Brahmachari, that's why he was Brahmachari, Krishna Vallabh Brahmachari, and other Brahmacharis there. Paramya Madhava Goswami Maharaj going for preaching there. Maybe I heard about Krishna Vallabh Brahmachari, other Brahmacharis there. Then they are preaching going on. So Madhava Goswami Maharaj took decision. We can do first preaching, we'll have to make grouping. First group can go preaching here, second group there, third group here, three. We can divide out because otherwise it's impossible. Then after that, Paramya Madhava Goswami Maharaj is going some place for preaching. He is sending some devotees for preaching other place. This way preaching going on. One day, actually, some Assamese people, they are coming in front of the devotees, Sankirtan going on, Sankirtan Harikatha going on. They are very angry with stick and everything. They are coming and beating devotees and breaking their heads, all blood coming out without any reason. They are fighting with devotees. Why you are speaking Harikatha? We don't believe. Fighting. Big. Then most of the devotees, they are going to hospital, they are sent to hospital. Then some devotee, somehow, were coming very fast in front of Madhava Goswami Maharaj. Then just his Harikatha just finished, Madhava Goswami that preaching there. Just finished, then he's running and crying, falling on lotus feet of Madhava Goswami Maharaj. The Gurudev, what happens? Everything lost. What happens? But there some Assamese people coming and pitying those devotees. They are cracking their bread, they are actually hate, they are breaking their heads, everything. They are sent to hospital. What do you see? Yes, they are now in hospital, they are almost dying. And Madhava Goswami Maharaj not speaking anything, only speaking one thing. Ah, Krishna! This way. Only one word. Not speaking, only one word. Ah, Krishna! And crying. That night, some mad elephant from forest coming and there's that village and those who are attacking devotees, especially those room, their house. There's elephant, mad elephant, they actually breaking their house, their children, they die, killing them and gone. This way Paramahansa Madhava Goswami Maharaj speaking. I heard from Paramahansa Bhakti Vallabha Krishna Goswami Maharaj that Maharaj, you cannot imagine what kind of situation is there. There is not at all favorable situation. At present, if you ask some devotees to go for preaching there, first you can what kind of facility I can give? And how many devotees can come? First question. They are like to hear the prospect. They like to get money, they like to get disciple, a nice situation. If two or three people or 10 people coming, we cannot go. If thousands of people, then I can go. Pure devotees, what is the symptom of pure devotees? They are less interested about money, situation. If there is one devotee, they can speak. There are lakhs of devotees, they can speak. It's not a matter. They are speaking for the total satisfaction of Krishna. They are speaking Harikatha, they are doing Kirtan for the satisfaction of Supreme Lord. That is not their personal benefit. They are not seeking anything, personal benefit. That's why Krishna Vallabha Brahmachari, Ati Paramahansa Bhakti Vallabha Krishna Goswami Maharaj, Maharaj, you cannot imagine what kind of situation was there. So, Guru Maharaj used to take me with him. One day we are going to a village. There is no light, almost forest. Some Assamese people, they are not understanding Bengali even 100%. Few years and they understand. Because Assamese language and Bengali, they are just nearby. They guess, somehow they guess, they understand. So, Paramahansa Madhava Goswami Maharaj, Hayagriva Brahmachari, that time actually Madhava Goswami Maharaj took sannyas. I can speak about this point. So, doing preaching, and night time, no room. Where to stay? No place to stay. Who can give you money? Who can arrange your stay? They are all poor, tribal. They are tribal, very poor. They somehow they arrange their prasadam, these there. I mean, food, ordinary food. Then Paramahansa Madhava Goswami Maharaj used to stay there in forest. Almost forest. Village means almost forest. Snack going on. Bhakti Vallabha Krishna Goswami Maharaj speaking, Maharaj, you cannot imagine. They with bamboo, they're making some sort of bunk. Bunk, you know, in train. You can have first bunk, second bunk. You can find one. Three-tier, train. There, Assamese people, they're making this kind of bank. They have first bank with bamboo. First bank, second bank. My Guru Maharaj sleeping in first bank. I'm sitting in third bank. This way, at night time, I see the snack going on. But still, we are very... We have belief that Gurudev is there. We believe the 100%. This way, Madhava Goswami Maharaj speaking, preaching, I see. The tribal people, by the appearance of Madhava Goswami Maharaj, by the appearance on the scene, What about hearing Harikatha and Kirtan? Only by appearance, Madhava Goswami used to change. Those tribal people, poor, very poor people, their son, their father, they are all coming to take shelter of Gauri Amat. They are coming gradually. Madhava Goswami is preaching this way. By appearance, you cannot believe. By appearance, Bhakti Mohan is speaking, by appearance, only if you can have a chance to see a Vaishnava can purify you. Darshane pavitra kara ek tumar guru. My guru used to give one example. My son, you cannot believe this point. Narottama Thakur going for pitching in. Where? In Tripura. In Mizoram, Tripura, Nagaland. Mizoram, Tripura, Nagaland. Eastern. Extreme eastern part. Narottama Thakur preaching. And Sanava Srinivasaji was giving order for preaching in Orissa and some place there, nearby Minnabu. And Bankura and this side, preaching totally done by Srinivasacharya. Big preaching. So kind of a problem coming in for actual preaching if you want to do. So there, Narottama Thakur in Manipur, doing kirtan in one temple there, and those people coming to see Narottama Thakur, where from this kind of kirtan coming, this kirtan is so strong, they pulling their heart. Narottama Thakur kirtan pasa nikuti bo matha anole po sibo, playing kirtan, doing kirtan. And those common people, they don't understand Bengali language. But Narottama Thakur doing kirtan in Bengali language. It is excellent thing. But still, they are coming and crying in front of Narottama Thakur. In front of Narottama Thakur, my Guru was speaking, they don't understand language. But still, they are crying. When Narottama Thakur doing kirtan, they are crying and they are feeling some sort of ecstatic feeling. Doing kirtan. Why? Prabhupada used to speak, Hari Kirtan, Hari Katha is not Bengali language, not English language, nor Hindi language. It is not confined with this language matter. It is beyond language matter. It is the code language of heart, Hari Katha. My Guru Maharaj used to speak me, order me, you go and speak Hari Katha in Bengali, sometimes English. So those English people, they say, now Maharaj is going to speak Bengali. Why? My Guru says, hey, still we have to sit there. Though Bengali Hari Katha going. Because transcendental sound can have a kind of reaction inside your heart. You have some influence. I can give example again and again. Many examples I can give. Haridas Thakur and Gauranga Mahaprabhu discussing, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu asking, Haridas, those who are, stubborn mean, is the matter. Stone, chip, iron, how they can get benefit? Stubborn mean? Cannot move. How they can get benefit? Haridas Thakur, Prabhu, when he was speaking, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, then our sound vibration going. You can feel some echo. Haridas Thakur began, it seems it is echo. It is like echo, but it's not actually echo. They are responding. Haridas Thakur speaking. Sound is getting one bounce and coming back. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. 100% true. Now scientists who are advanced science are speaking any sound you speak here, a vibration going on. And from America or in Australia, they can catch the sound. Shabda Taranga, find by sound, began. If you read with science about sound vibration, then you can understand. big influence. So all those who are not understanding language, they cannot understand language, still their sound vibration can go and touch their heart, also very good for them. Haridas Thakur was speaking this way. So actually, Narottama Thakur singing kirtan, doing kirtan, but that sound is not ordinary sound. It's transcendental sound. So though they don't understand language, but still they are feeling some kind of, you know, influence. That's why they are crying. One day Popa speaking Harikatha there in South India some place. 2 hours Popa continuously speaking Harikatha. 2 hours continuously Popa speaking Harikatha, but in Bengali language. Continuously 2 hours over. Then after completing Harikatha, Hayagi Brahmachari is talking on Goswami Maharaj. They are there. Aprakito Brahmachari says, Popa, they don't understand Bengali. You speak Harikatha in Bengali? Popa very hard. I'm not speaking Bengali. I'm not speaking English. I'm not speaking Hindi. I'm not speaking Malayalam. I'm speaking Harikatha. Really so. Big devotee, they can prove this point, actually. So this way, actually, Paramahansa Madhava Goswami Maharaj is preaching, oh, Assam, so at present, we are ever grateful, to Paramahansa Madhava Goswami Maharaj. Because at the time of Prabhupada, Assam preaching was done, but not so big. Only Nimananda Prabhu, one Grihastha devotee, very powerful Grihastha devotee. Nimananda Prabhu was there at the time of Popa. And it was the standing instruction by Popa on, you see, Nimananda Prabhu, standing instruction. That any people, any body like to take shelter of Gauriyama, first of all I give order, you can give Harinam preliminary. Because they are very poor. They cannot afford. They cannot come here, long distance, train, fare, this, that. First of all you can give Harinam. And after giving Harinam, 1 year, 2 year, wait and watch. If you see they are favorable, then you can bring them here in Mayapur. I can give Harinam to them at the time of Gaur Purnim. Because at the time of Gaur Purnim, they can have the chance to do circumambulance, Dham Parikram. So Dham Parikram means they are giving 50%, more than 50% Kipa. Dham Kipa is topmost Kipa. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving instruction to Prabhupada, Vimala Prasad. It is your duty to arrange Dham Parikrama. It is your duty to install Daivavarnasram. Before leaving this material world, Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving instruction to Prabhupada, Vimala Prasad. It is your duty to install this Daivavarnasram system. You will have to arrange again. It is almost lost. And you will have to arrange your Dham Parikram. Because through Dham Parikram is topmost. Through Dham Parikram, you can get Kipa. Dham is so merciful. Dham, so merciful. I give one example, you see, you can remember. I want to give this example. Actually, Ashwatthama, you heard the name of Ashwatthama doing so big aparat in Krishna Lila. Ashwatthama is killing the children of Panchapandav. You heard? The Ashwatthama doing so big aparat, even Krishna is less interested to see his face. Even Harinam cannot help him. So big aparad. He is killing Vaishnava. Panchapandav, their children, Vaishnava. In Vaishnava family, Vaishnava there. After that, in this, Asatama developing that kind of body, which you can compare with a ghost. Ghost, you know? Pisach. Which? Daini, Pisach, you can compare. His body is so bad smell coming, within 2 or 3 kilometers, nobody can stay when Asatama is there. Yes! Asatama, in his very life, is developing that kind of bad, you know, body. If Asatama is there, within 2-3 kilometers, nobody can stay. So bad smell coming. Pishach, in Bengali you say. Ghost. That Asatama crying. I have done problem. I have done aparad. Okay. But if aparad is there, there must be one way out. What is the way out? After that, some devotee giving you advice, some rishi. You go and do dam seva. Today or tomorrow, Krishna is bound to give you kripa. Dam. Where to go? You go to Brajadam. Still today, Asatama doing, because his body is not going to, you know, 1 month, he is going to live more and more. Asatama is not dying so easily. He has benediction. He is not going to die. Asatama is there now. Still you can get Asatama there. In Pisaigaon, one village is there, name is those who are doing Churasikos Parikrama, 84, cross parikrama, sometimes they have the chance to go there. I've been there. Very nice place. Nobody can see Asatama. Asatama doing bhajan there. Nobody can see. In one for near Nandagram. From Nandagram, almost 5 kilometers east and west. You have to go. Corner. There one way I've been there. Very. Asatama still today doing dam seva to get kripa. Still Krishna is not favorable with him. With him. He's doing. Someday dam can do kripa and he can get. He can go out of this, you know, curse. Avisha. Like Jagai Madhai, when getting full kripa from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they cannot believe that Prabhu can give full kripa to us. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, from today onward, nobody should point out their past evil activities. Their activity is very bad. But at present, from today onward, nobody can point out anything. Because from today, they are pure. I give kripa to them. Then Jagai Madhai crying, how we can believe that you are giving full kripa to us? Well, then you can go and clean ghat. Ghat, you know, where the devotee, they like to take bath. Jagai Madhai ghat is there. The Jagai Madhai used to cry and clean dham. Dham seva? Dham seva, they are cleaning. Any devotee is coming, they are crying. But previously we are so notorious. We don't know, today we are getting kripa from you all. So don't remember, never mind what kind of operation we have done in our life. But still, please give blessing. This way, those devotees coming to take bath in Ghat, Ganga, they have the chance, and they are cleaning. With boom, they are cleaning Ghat. This way, if you have the chance to clean Dham, many, many devotees there in Vrindavan, simple, one seva they are doing, cleaning dham. Even you heard about Narottama Thakur. Narottama Thakur cleaning dham. Loknath Goswami going, externally you can see latrine job as this transcendental body. Still, Narottama Thakur cleaning dham. With dham seva, getting guru. They are eternal prasad, but still they are exhibiting this kind of leela. So this way you see, Asatama doing bhajan, dham. So this way, Prabhupada used to give order to Nimananda Prabhu, Haikya Brahmachari, you can go for preaching there. But after Nimananda Prabhu used to give Harinam, Nimananda Prabhu, if after 1 or 2 years, Nimananda Prabhu, if he was in this devotee is very nice, can take Diksha, then he used to keep bringing here. And they can have the chance to do Parikrama also, and full Kipa they can give Diksha. This way, massive preaching was done in assembled by Parampajira Madhava Goswami Maharaj. So ultimately, one mot was installed there, established in Assam. First mot is Sarbhog. You heard the name of Sarbhog? Sarbhog, one place, very important place, in big highway. I've been there, actually. So there in Sarbhog, first in Assam's first Gaudiya Math was established. Sarbhog. So the all pure poor people there. They are waiting because Prabhupada coming. So Prabhupada now from Assam, from the station, they arrange elephant. On elephant they put Prabhupada, with marching kirtan and sankirtan they are bringing Prabhupada. Haikir Brahmachari also there. That time sannyas was not done. Later on. Now after that they are coming with big procession. All Assamese people, they can do nice kirtan. They are very simple hearted. Their heart is very plain. They are coming and doing kirtan. They bring Prabhupada. After that, you see, deity installation was done, Mandir, temple. From then Assam preaching was strong, you see. Then after that, actually, Punjab preaching was totally done by Paramjaya Madhava Goswami Maharaj. All Mayavadi people there, they don't understand what is bhakti. They don't understand. This way thing was quite impossible. Mayavadi people. This way, by appearance and kirtan, Madhava Goswami Maharaj used to preaching, you see. One day, Paramjaya Madhava Goswami Maharaj and some of his god brothers, they are discussing among themselves. Prabhupada always giving us order to do 1 lakh Harinam. Because this is the instruction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, those who are not doing 1 lakh Harinam, from them Chaitanya Mahaprabhu cannot accept water. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving instruction in Chaitanya Charitamrita, those who are doing 1 lakh Harinam, only from them, pure Harinam, from them I can accept water. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking. So this way, Prabhupada giving instruction, each one of them should do Harinam 1 lakh. So someday they are discussing among themselves, God brothers, Je Prabhu, how to do 1 lakh Harinam? Whole day we are doing seva, we have no time to do chant 1 lakh Harinam. So we must ask in front of Prabhupada, what is the procedure, what is the way out? Because you are giving instruction to do Harinam, 1 lakh Harinam. Then they are giving instruction to Hayagri Brahmachari, Prabhupada love you very much. So you can ask Prabhupada. We have no power to go in front of Prabhupada. Anybody, those who are coming in front of Prabhupada, they cannot speak anything. So heavy personality. So you can ask Prabhupada. Prabhupada. You can approach Prabhupada. We cannot go. We cannot speak with Prabhupada. The all the senior god brothers, they are giving instruction. Then one day, Haikur Brahmachan in Assam, maybe in Sarbhog, this thing happened. So this time actually, Madhava Goswami Maharaj, Haikur Brahmachari, Prabhupada doing Harinam in Baranda, doing Harinam, Hitarandita, right, doing Harinam, going there. And Haikir Brahmachari also with pen, hand pen. This way, going there, here and there. Prabhupada going backside, doing After the Prabhupada, I like to speak of what thing? I want to ask one thing to you. What? Now actually you give instruction to us to do 1 lakh harinam. But we cannot make up our time to do 1 lakh harinam, what to do? Whole day seva, this, that. Prabhupada looking at Hayagriva Mahamaja. Why? Night time what you are doing? Night time what you are doing? You must do harinam night time. Don't sleep. This way, Prabhupada so hard. Madhava Goswami used to be. After that, you know, his appearance was so nice, Madhava Goswami's appearance, that all big minister, big money, material people used to come in favor of. In Punjab, Ludhiana, in Jalandhar, everywhere, Amritsar. Bhakti Vallabhi Thakur used to say, Maharaj, you cannot imagine. That time, they used to speak Harikatha 4 times in a day. He said, what do you say? Now one Maharaj and I am speaking about myself. I am a very poor man actually. How I can speak? So 4 times. Morning time, noon time, noon time, evening time and night time. 4 times. In a day, every day, they are speaking 4 times. And all people from village and different place, they are coming to hear their Harikatha. In Amritsar, Jalandhar. Now you go, you can find there are so many devotees. They are dancing and doing kirtan. 4 times, they are kirtan. By appearance, catching everybody. So now actually, in Amritsar, one day, the place I went there. I've been there actually. Actually, Paramjaya Madhava Goswami Maharaj in one temple, actually, that place is not, you know, pure place actually. But is Vaishnava going is okay. Actually, for Mayavadi place almost. Madhava Goswami Maharaj going there, what to do? No place is there. So somehow they arrange to do bhikkha and cooking themselves, not so much Vaishnava etiquette, so pure. Anybody like to give bandara, Madhava Goswami Maharaj used to. Our brahmachari is there, they like to cook, they can cook. Outside people cannot cook. So Madhava Goswami Maharaj doing sankirtan, dancing. And thousands of people in Amritsar, they are coming to watch that Mahapurush. So much people coming to hear and see. After that, you see, next day, so many people coming and asking in front of Brahmachari, Krishna Vallabha Brahmachari. Today also that kind of kirtan, we hear that kind of kirtan, also we like to. So they are so attractive. So after the Punjab Prachar, you see everywhere. In Punjab itself, in Punjab you can find so many temples. Not only Delhi. Delhi is a separate Union Territory. Delhi, in Punjab, Chandigarh, Bhatinda, everywhere you can find mart. All the Gaudiya Math devotees there actually. Everywhere. This way, all over Punjab, Paramya Madhava Goswami Maharaj doing. Big appreciation. Now, if you go, you can see. For common people, it is not possible actually. And in Chandigarh itself, Chandigarh is so costly place. Chandigarh is actually so costly place, there nobody can make a temple. It's impossible, almost impossible. And that time is also, you see, that time Gaudiya Math preaching is also just started. Then, Madhava Goswami Maharaj want to make math, one very temple, Gaudiya Math there, established. B sector, 20 sector, quite impossible. So corporation, one corporation places there, big ground. Then some, you know, minister, I mean some MLA, this, they want to help Madhava Goswami Maharaj, but not that way what he want to mean. Madhava Goswami says, I like to give this place. Maharaj is quite impossible to give this place. You cannot give this place. How you can expect so important place? Then Madhava, by the influence of Madhava Goswami Maharaj, they are bound to give this, select this place. They are bound. They cannot say no. Now you can see Chandigarh Math is there. So this way Madhava Goswami Maharaj is preaching. After that, for some time, Madhava Goswami Maharaj was Acharya of after Prabhupada, I am speaking. After Prabhupada gone, something happened. We need not discuss this point because some of the ordinary people cannot understand this point. Common people cannot misunderstand. This is a must, you see. Otherwise, how big preaching can be done? All of our God brothers, I mean, of Madhava Goswami Maharaj, I mean, those who are disciples of Prabhupada, they are lion. Lion always staying alone. So they are going here and there, making different all over the world now, preaching going on. This way, you see, some problem happened. After that, Madhava Goswami Maharaj going out. Then after that, he was Acharya of Chaitanya Math for some day. Hayagi Brahmachari was made Acharya of Chaitanya Math for some days. And then actually, Damodar Maharaj, Paramya Bhadur Bharati Goswami Maharaj, Damodar Goswami Maharaj, Bhaktivala Tittu Goswami Maharaj, they all came that time. When he was Acharya of Chaitanya Math, that time. Due to some reason, again he was displaced from that Acharya seat. Hayagi Brahmachari now requesting that, I never requested you all to make me Acharya. You all took decision to make me Acharya. Now what is my fault? Can you point out one fault? They cannot point out fault. Due to some jealousy, then big problem. Now I am making disciple everything, you give order. Now you are against me unnecessarily. No reason is there. Where I can go with disciple and so many? I make a where to go? No place to stay anyway. We don't know, you will have to go away from this place. Unnecessary. No reason. Whole life of Paramya Madhava Goswami Maharaj is stainless. Whole life of Madhava Goswami Maharaj is stainless. Due to some reason, Patishtha. Some problem took place. Then Madhava Goswami Maharaj crying, Hayagri Brahmachari going out of math. No place to stay. Nobody to help. Only Chaitanya Mahaprabhu there, going to Calcutta. Then some devotee, he is helping. I have one place in Baligonj. In Baligonj, in Calcutta, one place is there. I have one shop room, shop, actually, long, like this room, long shop. It is almost closed. At present, you can stay there for 6 months or 1 year. I allow you. In that shop, Madhava Goswami Maharaj staying with all these, you know, disciples. Crying day and night. Believe Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Oh Prabhu, if you want, then I can do preaching. Personally, I have no desire. You create this kind of situation, Prabhu. I don't blame you. Maybe some plan and program is there of Supreme Lord. That's why I am put it into this kind of bad situation. Okay. Bad situation, never speak. Madhava Goswami never speak, I am put it into bad situation. Because bad situation and good situation, if you can see equally, then that is called Vaikuntha Darshan. You understand? Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj speaking, Prabhupada also speaking, bad situation and good situation, if you are looking equally, then you are having Vaikuntha Darshan. Then your darshan is very clear, flawless darshan. Any problem you create, but still if I am not against you, you are making so much problem against me. Still I am not against you. If I have the chance to look the whole world in connection with Krishna, in relation with Krishna, then how I can go against you? A Vaishnava is so pure, he cannot go against anybody. There cannot be any kind of hostile attitude. Huh? Then Madhava Goswami Maharaj being preaching there in Calcutta? In Calcutta itself, is the mercy of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. You see, mercy of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. This time you see Madhava Goswami Maharaj asking all devotees, those who are disciples of Madhava Goswami Maharaj, you can go to home you can go and put one mud, patra, pot made of mud. Mud, you know? Sometimes some village people, they are making one pot in which every day they put 1 rupee coin, depositing. This way, Paramya Madhava Goswami Maharaj, giving order to all of his devotees, you go home to home and put one box there. They can sometimes put coin, another box they can put some rice. Every day they are cooking mother, those who are mother, they are cooking every day. So they can, when they are cooking, they can take some rice and put into that box. So after 1 month or 15 days, we can go collect what kind of rice, all. You understand? This kind of collection. Home to home, they are going. So this way, they are not feeling pain because they are poor. If some little rice, if you give me, you have not thinking because a very small amount. This way, no pressure is there. So this way, Madhava Goswami Maharaj used to lead his life, Bhikkha, Madhukuri Bhiksha. This way, Paramaya Madhava Goswami Maharaj used to do Madhukuri Bhiksha. That time he is speaking Harikatha in Calcutta, here and there, Baliganj. Then those who are against Madhava Goswami Maharaj, unnecessarily, they are printing some pamphlet, you know, handbill, writing all rubbish against Madhava Goswami Maharaj. He is actually useless personality. He was in Chaitanya Math. He took money and everything from Chaitanya Math. He is speaking all rubbish. Don't hear his Harikatha. This way they are writing and distribute in front of public. Those who are hearing Madhava Goswami Maharaj. Madhava Goswami giving lecture in front of public. In the meantime, they are distributing pamphlet. One pamphlet, Madhava Goswami Maharaj looking at that pamphlet. One pamphlet. He had the chance to see one pamphlet was there. You see. Madhava Goswami Maharaj laughing. Very nice. Very nice. Then after that, Madhava Goswami Maharaj speaking in such a way, so that those people who was coming here, they 100% they believe that is actual sadhu. Because at a glance, if you look at one sadhu, you can know he is genuine or not. His genuinity is proved. Because though they are distributing pamphlet, but still he is not angry. That is the document, 100% document, he is pure sadhu. This is fishing. After that, making nice temple there in Satish Mukhaji Road, All our Guru Varga, you can see. They are making temple, different place. But Madhava Goswami Maharaj making temple, you see the location of all temples. You can go and watch. Location. In Assam, Guwahati, in Calcutta, anywhere you go, all main place, quite impossible. Main place. In Vrindavan even. Vrindavan, in our Vrindavan we say big mart. All those devotees are speaking, Bada mart, big mart. Yeah, he making. Everywhere. One day Prabhupada going through that road, Prabhupada pointing out, this is the place where Sradharani used to stay. Those who are king, like Vishwanu Maharaj, Nanda Maharaj, they have different facility. Because they are king. Gargamuni. Gargamuni is a native land, native place is Brajabhumi. Gangroli one place. Gangroli, Gangrol. That is the village house of Gargamuni. Also, Guru Gargamuni used to stay there in Mathura. So, Vishwanu Maharaj also in, you know, they are in Barsana, here in Vrindavan. What do you say, Vrindavan? Vrindavan is totally Vrindavan. Vrindavan city, now you speak. There also, Paramahansa Prabhupada actually speaking when going. Long ago, Prabhupada said, this is the place where Radharani used to stay. Used to say. So this place, actually, Paramahansa Madhava Goswami has got. The Bada Mat there. This way, all involved in Dehradun. Where not? Where not? Everywhere. One day, Prabhupada took decision to send Hayagri Brahmachari to foreign country. Because he can preach nicely. Then some elderly, senior devotees, they are coming in front of Prabhupada. Prabhupada, Hayagri Brahmachari is so nice looking, so handsome. So, Prabhupada, if you send, then there can be some problem. Prabhupada laughing. Well, we are not going to, because you are Vaishnava, we cannot send. we can stop. Okay. They are not send. So, nice looking. You see, this way Madhava Goswami is preaching everywhere. Now you see, at present, everywhere. Gauri Chaitanya, Gauri Mart, Calcutta, here, everywhere he is doing. Now actually, we are grateful to Paramahansa Madhava Goswami Maharaj because he is always preaching against Mayavad. That's why we are grateful. Prabhupada speaking, so long as Mayavad Siddhanta is Prabhupada speaking, so long as Mayavad Siddhanta is there in this material world, till then, pure preaching is not possible. So we are ever grateful to Madhava Goswami Maharaj because he was always against Mayavad. Always, you know, cutting Mayavad everywhere. One day, Paramahansa Madhava Goswami Maharaj going to Allahabad, you know Allahabad? Ganga, Jumna, Saraswati, three, confluence of three rivers. There Madhava Goswami Maharaj, why? There actually Kumbh Mela. Kumbh Mela, you know? You heard Kumbh Mela? Different kind of devotees, they can come from different sampradaya. They have the chance to go there. Big congregation. There if you can project this Gauranga philosophy, Chaitanya philosophy is very interesting. Then common people can have the chance to hear Kumbh Mela. Billions of devotees, they are coming to take. That is a chance. That's why Madhava Goswami Maharaj, they are opening one place there. One stall. Nice stall. On behalf of Chaitanya Gauri Maharaj. Still today, Madhava Goswami Chaitanya Gauri Maharaj, they are opening stall. You see, at the time of Prabhupada also, at the time of Prabhupada, that was the usual rule. To open one stall, book stall, Harikatha also used to, they used to speak, prasadam system also. There actually, Madhava Goswami Maharaj going there to speak all about Gauranga Philaya Chaitanya Vani. By chance, there is one big congregation of different sampradaya. They invite Madhava Goswami Maharaj. He was this very famous man. You must come to speak Harikatha there. Madhava Goswami Maharaj going there. Very nice. Then after that, there, topmost Pandit in India. Though externally, I don't like to say, yes, Mayavadi, this, I cannot speak this way. I should not speak this way. Because this is already, I cannot speak this way. His name is actually Karpatri. You heard name of Karpatri? Topmost Pandit. That time. From Varanasi. Is coming. He never used vehicle, he never used chapal, he never used utensil, nothing. Karpatri means take prasadam in hand, take and wash hand. So big, You see, Karpatri. Karpatriji was there, president of that Sava. Then Karpatriji giving order to everybody to speak Harikatha. After that, now Madhava Goswami is speaking Harikatha. After Harikatha is over, after the Sava is over, function is over, then Karpatriji passing remark, the way Madhava Goswami is speaking, and that is topmost. We must believe. Though we are all Pandit and big, big Vidyan, but still, what Madhava Goswami is speaking, we must accept it. Big. All clapping. Madhava Goswami Maharaj ki jai. So big. Everywhere. Wherever you send, Prabhupada used to send Madhava Goswami, Hargip, they are failure to do this seva there. Can you go? Yes, Prabhupada. Whenever everybody failure, follow me. Whenever everybody failure to do that seva, then ultimately Prabhupada giving order to Hayagriva. Hayagriva, everybody failure. Can you go there to do this seva? Yes, I can go. One example I can give. In Madras, that time, Mayabad belt, I already told you, Prabhupada want to make one Gaudiya Math there in Madras. I mean South India. Everywhere, especially in Madras, Kobur, that's quite impossible. They are less interested to hear about Chaitanya philosophy. If they sit in front of you, then you speak and mold them. If you don't, if they are less interested to hear you, then how you can speak Harikatha? They are less interested. Then that Madhava Goswami Maharaj, Popa sending Madhava Goswami Maharaj, and you see, Aprakita Brahmachari, I mean Aprakita Prabhu, Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Shaudha Ashram Maharaj, they are top looking, very nice person they are going. They are doing preaching. But previous batch, when first batch they are failure. They are coming back to Prabhupada giving report. Prabhupada, it is quite impossible to make many mart preaching there. Really so, yes. Now I call Hagi Brahmachari and is there. Can you go there? Yes, we can go. They are going. They are starting preaching. And those old batch, first they go. They are saying, why you are coming here? Qua preaching or impossible. We are failure. You are useless, actually. You can waste your money and energy. Madhava Goswami has taken let me see. By Guru Kripa, we can start preaching and let us see what kind of preaching can be done. But up to now, no effective preaching done. Madhava Goswami says, ekhono porjonto kono bishesh prachar to hoyni. Up to now, not effective preaching not done. Actually, let us see. Why you are going to lose your hope? We can go there. Then Madhava Goswami started preaching. First of all, Madhava Goswami started preaching. Some important people all around this city, they are attending Harikatha in different language, English and different language. Then after that, Madhava Goswami Maharaj, they are preaching. Then Madhava Goswami Maharaj requesting Prabhupada to come here. If you can come here, Prabhupada, then preaching can be done. Prabhupada speaking, well, first of all, you do preaching. After then, if you can arrange one small room, at least if I can go and stay there, then I can do preaching. Prabhupada speaking. Then they are preaching nicely in different place. After that, from ex-mission, I cannot speak name. From ex-mission, they are inviting Hayagi Brahmachari. And they are also inviting different sadhu from different sampradaya. They are also going, mane, from ex mission, from Gaudiya Math, from Y mission, different mission. Some rich people, very very rich people, inviting. You Gaudiya Math, you can also come from ex mission. They are also come. They can speak Harikatha. So people have the chance to different kind of philosophy. Madhava Goswami Maharaj is going there, speaking Harikatha there. After Harikatha is over, they are arranging prasadam. Their prasadam, you know, fish, meat, everything. Their prasadam, ex-mission, you know, you understand my point. Then that rich people, he is in favor of ex-mission. He become very angry. Madhava Goswami Maharaj speaking, now our Harikatha is over preaching, if you give permission, we can go. Why? There is an arrangement for prasadam you can take. Actually, we cannot take prasadam here by the instruction of Guru Maharaj. Why? You are sadhu, they are not sadhu. They are also sadhu, they are taking prasadam. They are speaking in front of Madhava Goswami Maharaj. Madhava Goswami is very humble. Well, actually, they are sadhu. We are not sadhu. We are very weak. They are very strong personality. They can take prasadam anywhere. They can maintain their power. We are so poor, without any power. That's why we cannot take. Say, please excuse us. Don't fight him. Never fight him. This way, Madhava Goswami never used to fight with anybody. Never. First of all, his behavior was so sweet. Madhava Goswami Maharaj, his behavior is so sweet. Catchy personality. He is speaking all about Chaitanyavan, but still, nobody can go against him. His preaching procedure is almost like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, preaching procedure of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is that Mahaprabhu can preach in front of Mayavadi. Mahaprabhu can speak in front of Buddhist. But still, after preaching is done, they are not against Mahaprabhu. Follow? So, sober personality is a speciality of Mahaprabhu. Even Kashivasi, Mahaprabhu is speaking all about absolute truth. Not going into compromise with Mayavadis. But still, his personality is so sober personality, catchy. After Harikatha is done, they are dancing with Mahaprabhu. They are Mayavadi. Prakasananda is a guru of 10,000 Mayavadi. With all full troops, I see. They are dancing with Mahaprabhu. That was the procedure of Madhava Goswami. Anybody come in contact with Madhava Goswami, he cannot go away. He cannot forget Madhava Goswami. So catchy person. This is the procedure. At present, some procedure, somebody following, they like to preach in such a way so that they can make problem for others. They can criticize other sampradaya, this, that. We need not criticize others. We can represent philosophy, darshan in such a way, our character, our activities, Vaishnava activities should be in such a way I should explain that they are not against me. They are very much interested to accept me. This is the pitching procedure. This should be. This way, one day in Jalandhar, Madhava Goswami Maharaj preaching, one day, lawyer, he is fighting with Madhava Goswami Maharaj. Fighting with Madhava Goswami Maharaj. I don't believe Supreme Lord. I cannot see. Can you show your God? Can you show? Same point was there from, you see, C.V. Raman. Scientist C.V. Raman, Nobel Prize owner. That time he was posted there in Calcutta Science College. C.V. Raman. Prabhupada sending Hayagya Brahmachari from Calcutta Gauriya Math, Bhagavad Gauriya Mission, to invite C.V. Raman to attain function, 1 month symposium, 1 month Harikatha. So, Hayagya Brahmachari going to invite C.V. Raman, scientists, to invite him there. Hayagya Brahmachari going there? There, actually, it is a system. First, we will have to write name and address. Then, man can go inside and show the paper. If he is interested to meet you, then he can give permission. Otherwise, you cannot give. Gate man is there. Then that paper was there. He write name, I like to meet Sivir. Why we invite him? And he's going into his room. Then Sivir Raman is less interested to meet that sadhu. So popped up. He's not looking. He's doing his job. Yes, go on speaking. Why are you coming? Madhava Goswami is not looking at me. Then he's doing his paper job. My Guru Maharaj is sending me to you to invite you to attend big function there in Calcutta, Gauriamat. We like to invite you. There's big symposium, 1 month, Harikatha. Then he readily become very angry. He's saying, what I cannot see, I cannot believe. I cannot go to waste my time there. He's speaking straightway. Madhava Goswami is instant speaking. Sir, what you can see? Can you see what is happening behind the world? Then he's looking at Madhava Goswami. When Madhava Goswami is speaking very straightforward this way, sir, can you see what is happening there behind the world? What you can see? Can you see bacteria, virus? And looking at. When look at that Mahapurush, Madhava Goswami, then half mold. Half molding done. Look at Madhava Goswami, so ajang lumbita bhujo, so I cannot explain. Effect of darshan, Vaishnava darshan. After that, C.V. Raman putting question. Your Gurudev can give Krishna to me? Can show? Your Gurudev can you show? Can you show Supreme Lord? Bhagavan? Madhava Goswami says, yes. Then show me. Scientist, C.V. Raman speaking. If you are speaking that you can show Supreme Lord, then now you show. Then Madhava Goswami is asking, Hayagya Brahmachari, sir, there is some procedure. What procedure? If I like to do research under your guidance, then what is the procedure? First you will have to go do your BSc, then you will have to do MSc, after that you have to keep your rank so that you can qualify for, you know, after that I can arrange one interview, after that I can select on what subject you like to do, if your subject is same subject I am interested, I mean I got doctorate, then you can. Then Madhava Goswami, Vaigra Brahmacharya says, same procedure is there, sir. Same procedure. First of all, you will have to go there to my Guru Maharaj and take shelter unto the lotus feet of Gurudev. You will have to follow my Guru Maharaj, do research work, I mean, they like your research work, do bhajan. After that, Guru Maharaj can show you. This is the procedure. When we are going to start bhajan, then if you start fighting with Gurudev, then you cannot get anything. Follow us. When you are going to start your bhajan life, first of all, if you start argument with Gurudev, then you have no chance for progress. You have? But progress you can do. I give one example. In Indian society, this is a system. When a child grow up, first, hate kori bole. First of all, when you start education, it is the system that Pandit coming, one sadhu coming, then the sadhu in front of Saraswati, Devi, Saraswati Devi. In front of Saraswati Devi, it is the system in Indian society, the child should write fast writing. Pandit can catch your hand, and he should write, oh, ah, you see, A, B, C, D, first. And that time, while you are just going to start your, you know, education life, if you start fighting with Pandit, I cannot believe this is A. What is the document? What is the proof? I can believe this A. Is there any evidence that is A, it is B, it is O, it is Co? Then you cannot start your education life. Madhava Goswami giving same example. Then C.V. Raman could understand. This way, you see, in Jalandhar also, one big lawyer, famous lawyer, is fighting with Madhava Goswami. Can you show yours? Can you show what? But I cannot see, I cannot believe. Can you show? Madhava Goswami Maharaj speaking. You must believe. Because this is the land, India is the land of spiritual cultivation. Those sages after long deliberation have given us immense stages of spiritual knowledge. But you are so full, you are less interested about it. Why you are speaking me foolish? I can speak some other day. Now you go away. Then one day that lawyer again come. Then he is speaking, Maharaj, my mind is not good today. What happens? This kind of fighting going on. Madhava Goswami Maharaj, you are speaking lie. Why? No, I am speaking friendly. My mind is very bad today. You are speaking lie. No, I am not speaking lie. My mind is very bad today. Can you show your mind? Black or white? Huh? How it looks like? Then that ukil become very stern. You cannot see your mind, but still you believe that your mind is there. Fine existence is there. Supreme Lord can expose His own feature in front of you. In Upanishad, Ved, Vedanta, everything is there. Document. Provided you are inclined unto the lotus feet of one Sadguru. If you go on doing your bhajan, today or tomorrow you can see. If you like to meet Supreme Lord, one Siddha Mahatma, he meet with Sadhu, Bhagavan, Supreme Lord. One Siddha Mahatma can see Supreme Lord. In Sandarbha, you can find different kind of procedure. I write one book, Bhagavad Sakatkar. Actually, it is written by some Maharaj, Sankolan. I mean just, he collects from different places. I was the editor of that book. Very small book. From total Sandarbha, like honeybee, collecting honey and putting, representing it. Bhagavad Sandarbha in Bengali. Very nice. There I give this example. Bhagavad Darshan, different kind of Bhagavad Darshan. Bhagavan, Supreme Lord can come in dream. Pratyakkha Darshan, direct Darshan. Parokkha Darshan, Aparokkha Darshan. Direct darshan you can get, like Dhruva Maharaj, Supreme Lord coming in front of Dhruva Maharaj. This kind of darshan is not always possible. But in dream you can get darshan. Like Madhavendra Puripa. Many times, Krishna coming in dream, one time coming directly, in guise of a coward boy and giving milk to Madhavendra Puripa. You can remember the story. This way, sometimes Supreme Lord can come indirectly. Suppose you are here, the room is locked. But inside you are doing bhajan, you can feel somebody is there. You can hear the voice, you can feel this devotee coming here. Indirect, not direct feeling. Somebody coming backside. The room is locked, but still you can feel. That devotee is there, indirectly. Another kind of darshan is there, through your whole life when you are doing bhajan, you can have direct feeling inside your heart. Like, I can give you an example, that when Bamandev took advent there, Kardam Rishi, now Kardam Rishi taking permission from wife, I like to go away from room. Already I told you, if one son is there in our life, then readily I can take sannyas. I told you, yes. Now, Bamandev already come. Kapildev. Kapildev, I'm sorry. I forget. Kapildev come. Then I like to go now. Sannyas, I like to take sannyas. Now there is Siddhanta, why he like to take sannyas? Because Supreme Lord already taking, has appeared in his own room, home. Supreme Lord already coming here in your room. Why you are taking trouble to take sannyas? What siddhanta? Yeah? What siddhanta? What siddhanta you can speak? Think. The Vishnu Chakotibad, Siddha Sahiba, they are speaking. There are those Supreme Lord coming in front of him. He like to go take sannyas because he like to get direct realization. Sometimes Chaitanya Mahaprabhu playing here. Chapal Gopal also have the chance to look at Mahaprabhu. Some dog, some jackal, they also have the chance to look at Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But that is not Tattik Darshan. Understand? When Supreme Lord appear, you can see. But that is not actually Bhagavad Darshan. Follow? Chapal Gopal doing opera, at the same looking at Mahaprabhu. He cannot believe that he is Supreme Lord. Follow what I mean to say. When Supreme Lord appear in this material world, everybody can have the chance to see. But that darshan is not Bhagavad Darshan. Otherwise, why Chapal Gopal was there in Mayapur, I mean Navadi. Always he is watching Mahaprabhu, but still he is doing opera. Doing opera? Then? So that kind of, to get that kind of direct feeling, that Rishi, Kardam Rishi, he took sannyas. So darshan, different kind of darshan. Direct darshan, indirect darshan, and direct feeling you can get through your acharan activities. 100%. Those who are pure devotees, they need not go to Nilachal Dham to watch Jagannath inside temple. From here, they can very clearly they can see Jagannath. When you are going inside Jagannath temple, there's so much, you know, trouble you take. But still you cannot see Jagannath properly. You can see only one. No hands, no leg. But one pure devotee, from anywhere, he can see Jagannath very clearly. Very clearly, more than you. You can get ticket, flight ticket or up to Bhuvaneshwar, this day you can go and take darshan of Jagannath. But still, you cannot see Jagannath. This is the system, see? This way, Paramya Madhava Goswami Maharaj preaching so heavily that still today we are remembering him, actually. So we are actually today we are expecting blessing from him. We pray unto his lotus feet, please bless us so we can follow you. All Guru Varga, all different Guru Varga, they have some kind of speciality. Keshav Goswami Maharaj has some speciality. Paramya Bano Goswami Maharaj has some speciality. Paramya Madhava Goswami Maharaj has some speciality. Paramya Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, Paramya Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. They have some kind of speciality. But for that, you should understand one point. If some Guru Varga has having some speciality, don't try to misunderstand him. Follow my point. Some speciality can be there. And you can say, well, my Guru Maharaj cannot speak this way. Why you are speaking this way? Don't speak like that. You should reconcile your heart. Then you can understand. Some speciality, Madhava Goswami Maharaj, some speciality. Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, some speciality. Paramya Keshav Goswami Maharaj says, many people I heard, they are criticizing against Paramya Keshav Goswami Maharaj. I give answer to them. Why Mahaprabhu Keshav Goswami Maharaj writing separate morning kirtan, arti kirtan? Bhakti Mathura already writing kirtan. Why Paramya Keshav Goswami Maharaj giving instruction not to follow Rasa Tattva from Jaiva Dharma at present? Why? They are fighting? But they cannot fight with me. I give fitting answer to them. Why Kesava Goswami Maharaj speaking this way? I give right answer to them. They cannot fight with me. They can speak backside. Because I am dog of my Guru Varun. Kesava Goswami Maharaj is there, I am his dog. If anybody speaks, I can bite him. Guru Varun. They are all my Guru Varun. Nobody can speak against them. Why Kesava Goswami Maharaj speaking? I give one answer. So that you can understand some different kind of philosophy, some kind of speciality can be there. Don't try to misunderstand any Guru Varun. Bhana Goswami Maharaj has a speciality there. But they misunderstand them. Why? Actually, Kesava Goswami Maharaj always very careful. When Jamakirtan going on, then Jamakirtan, for Jamakirtan, you need some kind of quality. If there is no quality in you, you have no chance to do Jamakirtan properly. Even if you do Jamakirtan morning time, you can see Radha Govinda sleeping. What is this? You can misunderstand. Morning time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Kirtan is very excellent. So Kesava Goswami Maharaj thought, Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving this kind of nice kirtan. But common people, those who are materialistic idea having, they can misunderstand Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhale gora gada dhari aruti nahari. So Kesava Goswami Maharaj writing nice kirtan under his guidance, under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. That kirtan is just, everybody can do kirtan. Even those who are not in line, this way, they can do kirtan. For them, to balance this, situation, is making this kirtan. Otherwise, how possible all Siddhanta Bhaktivinoda Thakur, all Siddhanta Prabhupada, we can hear from Kesava Goswami Maharaj. Even in the preface note of Jaiva Dharma, what Kesava Goswami Maharaj writing, you can watch. In preface note, what Prabhupada speaking, what Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj speaking. Jamakirtan is 100% right. Ultimately, you will have to go through Jamakirtan. But when you are not qualified, that then Jamakirtan cannot give result to you. That's why Kesava Goswami used to say, in Kartik, in the month of Kartik, in the month of Purushottam Vrata, you go on hearing about Sankirtan. Sankirtan, you go on hearing Harikatha from Sadhu. You go on hearing from elevated Sadhu. Bhagavad Katha, Harikatha, you go on. Today or tomorrow, you can develop that kind of quality. Then, that time, you can understand everything. That's why when Kesava Goswami Maharaj, when published Jaiva Dharma, Rasa Tattva was totally separate. I can show you. Even Bhaman Goswami Maharaj later on published Rasa Tattva because Gurudev instruction gave. Then those who are qualified, for them 100% it is necessary to go through Jamakirtan, Rasa Tattva, you can hear. Mahaprabhu also giving you instruction this way. It is in Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is already giving. Antaranga liya kare rasa sadhana, bahiranga liya kare nam sankirtan. With external people, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu doing sankirtan. And regarding rasa sadhana, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu entering into Gambira Mandir and close the door. Same thing. That's why we are not going to stop rasa tattva. 100%, you will have to get it. Prabhupada, I can show you what Prabhupada writing, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, what I can say. Prabhupada speaking, 100% will have to get this thing. Suppose you are now sick. Prabhupada giving this example. Prabhupada now speaking, suppose you are very sick. You develop liver problem. So doctor prescribes some very nice juice, fruits, fruit juice, this, that. Now you are not allowed to take rich food. Same thing Prabhupada speaking. Now you are not allowed to take rich food. Paramanna, Pushpanna, this way, no word. Doctor says, no, cannot take. Now you are sick. Prabhupada speaking same way. Now you are very sick. What disease? That is called materialistic disease. It is called material disease. It is called material disease. Eh? Now in this condition, if you like to take rich food, then you cannot digest. Babarok, in Bengali it is called babarok. Babarok, you know, in Bengali? Babarok, material disease. Prabhupada speaking, giving this example. If your liver condition is very bad, if you are sick, now you are not allowed to take rich prasadam. Krishna can digest anything. Krishna can digest fire also. Fire, taking fire. So you cannot digest. Same example, Prabhupada speaking. But when you get recovery, when liver problem is over, when you are now ekdam nice, fit now, no disease there. Now you can take rich prasad. Prabhupada giving this way. Rich food, then you can take. Prabhupada giving same example. I can open book and show you. Again, Prabhupada giving argument. For that, don't think it that way, that forever infinity reward we can go on taking the prescription of doctor. I mean, light prasadam, not that. Prabhupada giving, not, that doesn't mean for infinity reward it is a rule to take the, I mean, light food, like a patient, not that. We want to speak, Prabhupada speaking this way, the ultimate we will have to get this thing. Now we are sick, but not that we have taken resolution, whole life, life of our life, Bhartha Prabhupada, we can go on taking the, food of a sick people. Not that. I don't mean. We will have to get that thing. But first we will have to go out of this problem. I mean, Baba Rog, material disease should not be there. Anyway, first if you get, you are very nice, healthy person, then you can digest. Prabhupada giving same example. Also, I can open the book of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. In whole life, Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving different kind of, advice. Whole life on different topics. After 8 years, I published this book first. 8 years and 90 years. At the time of Prabhupada, it was published. After 8 years, it was published. That means Bhakti Vinod Bani Vaibhav. You heard this name? Bhakti Vinod Bani Vaibhav. All advice giving by Bhakti Vinod Thakur in his whole life. And Upadeshamrita. It is my request to you all, Upadeshamrita by Rupa Goswami Pad. But Upadeshamrita by Prabhupada Upadeshamrita. Upadeshamrita by Prabhupada. I mean all advice by Prabhupada. You must read it daily. Daily, if you want to become a great devotee, in this life, if you want to come out successful, we must follow Madhava Goswami Maharaj, we must follow Kesava Goswami Maharaj, we must follow Prabhupada. Otherwise, no way. There is a system. So be careful. So, jasyasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana sarvagunaistatro shamasate suraha harau avaktasya kuto mahadgunaha manorathena asato dhavato vahi vancha kalpadurusti kipasindu bhavajabhutidang pamana bhavishna bhyona. Any question if you have, then you can. It's very easy thing. Not big siddhanta I am speaking today. He took sannyas from Srila Vaishnava Goswami Maharaj. He took sannyas from Srila Vaishnava Goswami Maharaj there in Totakopinath Puri, inside Totakopinath. Actually, my Guru Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Paramahansa Gurudev, he took sannyas from Prabhupada in dream. Not in dream, almost dream. Not dream. Prabhupada coming and giving mantra to my Guru Maharaj, sannyas mantra. Then Guru Maharaj get up and there is paper and pen, Guru Maharaj writing this mantra. Still Guru Maharaj took sannyas from Parampujwar, Bhakti Gaurav Vaikhanas Goswami. Why? If I say Prabhupada giving me sannyas, nobody can believe, can express doubt, they can fight with me, so I can take sannyas. Again, Guru Maharaj took sannyas from Bhakti Gaurav Vaikhanas Goswami in Chapahati, Dijo Baninath place. Madhava Goswami Maharaj also took sannyas from same Vaikhanas Goswami Maharaj. Just 20 days ago, I am coming from South India. From there, I was Harikatha. If you open internet in Hindi, you can feel very enthusiastic. I was main speaker. They make me. I am very unfit, but still, if you understand Hindi, you can go mad. Anyway, actually, I don't like to go anywhere. If I get 100 invitation, I go one or two. Like that day, I went to Tibikam Maharaj. Never go, never take. They know Maharaj going not to take prasad and take fruit something. They can give. I can come. He is crying. What to do? That was not the situation I can speak Harikatha. But still Maharaj crying, you must come. That's why he went. Without any situation, Harikatha you can hear, but it's not, you cannot feel. Anyway. So you, if you have any question, he took sannyas form.
One question, but about future, where you observe purushottama mass.
Actually, I cannot promise you right now. It is not actually question. It is it is not actually Siddhanta question. Actually, from different place, they call me. Sometime I take decision from my Guru Maharaj, where to go, where not to go. Follow. So this time, from different place, call me. Not for many places, but one or two, like in Bankura, one Srinivas Acharya's place, Bankura. Bankura, one place is Srinivas Acharya. In Bengal, one place is the Bankura, there. And previous Purushottam Katha was there in Siliguri. Siliguri, if you can open, you can hear. You have to take from Purushottam. You can enjoy. And last Harikatha, Kartik, I couldn't speak because I was sick. Previous Harikatha was Siliguri in Milanpalli Math, Devananda Gaudi Math, Hindi. Hindi. But Hindi is very clear, Hindi, you can enjoy. Though you don't, if you don't understand Hindi, still you can enjoy. Very slowly, and in the four Bengali Harikatha you can get. Because morning and evening I am speaking Hindi, Bhagavad Katha. And by chance, if there is appearance day, disappearance day of Vaishnava, so noontime again speaking. So that Harikatha is Bengali, sometime Hindi. Four Bengali Harikatha, you can go at, you can hear. Anyway, so I cannot promise you right now.
That's just a small question, Maharaj. You had mentioned after Jaga and Madai, they were transformed and they became Vaishnavas. We should not talk about their past. But still we are mentioning what kind of people they were in order to glorify Mahaprabhu Goswami.
Actually, with if one Vaishnava, see, your point is very nice point. Very nice Siddhanta. Actually, when Krishnadas Gopiraj Goswami is speaking, Purisher Kuit Hoite Muhishe Logishto, when speaking, Jagai Madai Hoite Muhishe Babishto, when Krishnadas Gopiraj Goswami is speaking this way, that doesn't mean Krishnadas Goswami want to criticize them. Follow my point. Try to get the point, basic point. Krishnadas Goswami, Krishnadas Gopiraj Goswami is so humble. So humble, so humble, you cannot imagine. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, Purisher Kito, even those insects there you can find in stool. I mean, even in lower position than them. Krishnadas Kaviraj so humble. See, he want to speak this way. Jagai Madai, you can see their past. So sinful activities they have done. they did. Not done, not doing. But now when they are enjoying Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's kripa, you cannot compare them again. He is just comparing with himself. That doesn't mean Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami want to compare his life with Krishna Jagai Mata. He wants to represent this way, Jagai Mata is more elevated than me. More and more. And the situation, I mean the position of Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is excellent. First of all, hear me. Very good Siddhanta here. If you can remember, this point is Parashabhava Karmani no prasanshad nagarhe. In my past harikatha, sometime you can hear. Popa speaking. Popa sometime giving this sloka. Parashabhava Karmani no prasanshad nagarhe. Anybody doing any wrong activity, doing aparadha, pap, sinful activities, you have no right to point out. Why? He is doing all rubbish. I cannot speak. No. Because you are not out of influence of three modes of nature. You are within this. So you have no right. Even in Bhagavatam, if I have the chance to explain Bhagavatam, very, very lucid way, very sweet way I can discuss. I can show you in Bhagavatam first canto, when Parikshit Maharaj going out, outside to check up the condition of their his kingdom, and he meet with Kali. There's one point. Kali is just going to cut, you know, one cow, and bull is also there. You can remember. There one point I can discuss. When I can discuss Bhagavatam, I cannot mix. There you can find Parikshit Maharaj asking to bull, that bull, who are you? That bull not giving his own identification. After some time, Parikshit Maharaj is Mahabhagavat. Mahabhagavat is elevated personality. When that bull not going to give any identity about himself, what happens in your life? What problem? Why Gomata, cow, crying? What is the reason? I am king, you speak. I can take action. Then still he is not speaking. Then Parikshit speaking one slow. Now I know you are Shakshat Dharma. You are Dharmaraj. Now you can question how Parikshit can realize he is Dharma. Then Parikshit giving one slow. Ja papi papinam bhavet, suchaka sapi tat bhavet. If you are doing sinful activities, and if I criticize, then all the result that you are going to get, it can come to me. All result can. You can understand. Those who are doing sinful activities, if I just point out, he is doing this, then all this, his result, also I am going to get. Same result. If you are doing sinful activity, same result I can get in my life because I criticize you. Suchakasya opi tat bhavet. Those who point out, for them, same kind of punishment waiting. Suppose somebody murder somebody. He is a murderer, you know, the same punishment can come. Very nice, Siddhan. I am very happy that you. So if you don't put this question in front of me, I am not supposed to speak this secret point. If you want to become a devotee, don't try to criticize anybody. Don't try to find faults with others. Only try to find fault with yourself. Follow? So those who are staying under the influence of Mayadevi, they have no right to speak anything about you and me. But those who are staying in transcendental planet, like Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, like Bhakti Purvishri Maharaj, Bhakti BN180216 Maharaj, they can speak because they are not under the influence of Mayadevi. You can say, when Gurudev speaking, don't go there. He is doing woman association. Don't go there. Then do you think my Gurudev can fall down? No. He is equal side. Always says, darshan is equal, balanced. But still, he is speaking me so that he can save me. For that, when Gurudev giving instruction, sometimes good and bad he is speaking, for that he need not accept that kind of, you know, result. Follow my point, Siddhanta. You understand this Siddhanta? Those Guru Vaishnava sometimes speak heavily. Sometimes Prabhupada criticizing Mayavadi. Sometimes Prabhupada says, don't go there, come here. They are Sahaja. Prabhupada speaking loudly. For that Prabhupada is not going to get punishment. You follow? First of all, try to go out of the influence of Mayadevi. I mean three modes of nature. Guru Vaishnava can speak. They are not criticizing anybody. They are doing bhajan always, all the time. They can look Krishna inside their heart, all the time. If you look at them, you can understand. If you look at any Vaishnava, you, by their side you can understand. Their, you know, their looking is totally different. Their appearance can speak. They are looking Krishna inside their heart. They are less interested about what is happening in this material. Less interested. Billions of dollars you can put inside a room. You can give any kind of facility. They are less interested. They like to live their life, Madhukuri life they like to do. They are not going to take anything. You can test them. You can test them and see. Anyway, Yuktava. Very nice question, you see. So this way, if I have the chance to discuss secret Siddhanta, I can speak. If you have any doubt, then you can put it. Sometime if you find Madhu Goswami speaking this way, but Kesu Goswami speaking this way, but Manu Goswami speaking this way, I cannot understand why. Then you should reconcile your heart. Otherwise you can mislead, you can go. You can be misled. You can misunderstand. No, he's doing wrong. Your Shiksha Guru, Diksha Guru. First of all, if your Diksha Guru is Sadguru, elevated personality, very big, realize so, then what Diksha Guru speaking, that Diksha Guru what speaking, my Guru, my Diksha Guru, Srila Bhakti Daita. I cannot expect anything from my Guru Maharaj which is just against Prabhupada. Follow. I cannot expect any kind of teachings from my Guru Maharaj which is just against Prabhupada and Bhakti Mitra. Follow my point. If at all if I find Bhanu Goswami speaking this way, my Guru Maharaj never speak this way, then you will have to keep patience and approach that Maharaj. Maharaj, my Guru Maharaj speaks this way. Why you are speaking this way? Hey, he can. Or if he can approach one realized soul, he have the power to reconcile. He can speak. He is speaking this way. There is a, you know, harmonize. Otherwise, any time there is a question of fall down. Be careful, mother. I am less interested about how much people hearing my Harikatha. How much money I am giving. I am less interested. In Surya Kunda, only one man hearing Harikatha and singing Harikatha. Sometimes nobody there. To Krishna, I am reciting 8 hours, if not more, 8 hours reciting. Mool, only Sanskrit mool, reciting. So what? So be careful.